Hi, this is Rafiq Ibrahim, Interventional Cardiology Fellow from Egypt. It's my pleasure to participate in Cardiovascular Innovation Digital Forum this year, 2020. My case presentation is about intracoronary thrombus during STEMI, stenting, aspirate, or just wait. History and clinical data. 50 years old male patient, heavy smoker and hypertensive but not diabetic. He presented 12 hours after chest pain onset. ECG showed anterior STEMI, raised ST segment V1 to V4. Blood pressure was 110/70, pulse 100 beat per minute, CKMB and the troponin was positive. Echo showed marked septal wall and anterior wall hypokinesia with ejection fraction 50%. We decided to proceed with coronary angiography that showed total occluded LAD after proximal ectasia with retrograde filling from RCA. Coronary angioplasty. We used XP guiding catheter 3.5 to cannulate the LAD, and PT2 moderate support guiding wire was used to cross the proximal total occlusion. After multiple balloon inflation, an anti-grade flow TME2 was restored, but with high thrombus burden. So what is the next step? Our first option is direct stenting, but no clear landing zone and risk of no reflow. Second option, thrombus aspiration with a possible risk of stroke. Third option is to use glycoprotein 2P3A inhibitor infusion for 48 hours and reassess the LAD, but there is a possible risk of reocclusion. We picked our third option by using glycoprotein 2P3A inhibitor, especially have TME2 flow in the LAD. 48 hours later, there was significant improvement in thrombus burden and TME3 flow, but the challenge is where to place our stent. We used coronary drug eluting stent, 2.5 × 33 mm, was advanced to the distal LAD with good separation of stratus. Another drug eluting stent, 3 × 33 mm, was advanced to the proximal segment. Then a non-compliant balloon, 3.5 × 12 mm, was used for POT with very acceptable final result and TME3 flow in the LAD. My take-home message: intracoronary thrombus during STEMI is common and can lead to worse clinical outcomes. There is no gold standard therapy to deal with intracoronary thrombus. There are a combination of both pharmacological and the mechanical therapies that can be utilized. Aspiration thrombectomy shouldn't be used routinely in STEMI cases, but may be helpful in selected cases at the discretion of the operator. Large thrombus burden at time of primary PCI can lead to challenges with stent sizing, stent apposition, and final TME flow, which can in turn increase the risk of stent thrombosis. If high burden of thrombus is seen, defer the stenting with an interim period of adjunctive antiplatelet and antithrombotic therapy may be useful to reduce thrombus load and minimize complications such as no reflow at the time of stenting. Thank you.